let's open scriptures. God bless you. I believe I won't take long sharing the word of God. Let's read John 14. From verse 15 to 21. I'll give you many scriptures today. You can write. John 14. From verse 15. He says, verse 15, if you really love me, you will keep and obey my commandments. And I will ask the Father, he will give you another helper, comforter, advocate, intercessor, counselor, strengthener, standby, to be with you forever. The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it does not see him or know him, but you know him because he, the Holy Spirit, remains with you continually and will be in you. Can you see the verse there? I will not leave you as orphans. I will come back to you. After a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me because I live and you will live also. On that day, when that time comes, you will know for yourself that I'm in my Father and you are in me and I'm in you. The person who has my commandments and keeps them is the one who really loves me. And whoever loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and reveal myself to him, or I will make myself real to him. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I was reading this verse. I found that I must emphasize more what I'm going to teach today. Especially when I'm going to talk about God's word. Just write God's word again. God's word. Here I found that we cannot rush to talk about the things of the Spirit without keeping the word of God. Without carrying on doing what the word of God says. The Bible says, he who loves me will keep my commandments. Jesus was speaking about his ways. He will keep what I say. And that particular person, if he does that, I will pray to the Father. And the Father will give him Holy Spirit. I think today you are learning that Holy Spirit, you don't pray to get him. You keep the commandments and the Father will hear Jesus speaking that you need Holy Spirit. The second thing that we hear, that there will be the Spirit of the truth that you receive. The Spirit of the truth is the same Holy Spirit. You can check yourself when you are keeping the commandments if the truth is in you. The third thing there is, he said there will be revelations of you knowing him.
I will come
to manifest myself to you. I will make sure that you know me. I will appear real to you. Listen, the issue of Jesus is not a story or any tale. It's reality. So it's only God's word.
So
when we are obeying it, and when we are doing what the word of God says, and carry on doing that, Jesus will appear real. You know, I was with my visitors, we were talking about the issues of, one lady was asking me about the angels.
Motomo wa sesemo na bolela ka ba ruwa.
And he was talking about the issue of, I'm just giving example.
Ke no famo thala.
That of eating with the angels.
Ya uja le ba ruwa.
And I said, no, the angels are not there to eat our food.
Ba ruwa ba pi ona oto jari jo charina.
They are there to give us messages.
Ba ona o rifa midumo.
I'm sure you hear that.
Amen.
So I was telling her that, yes, you know, when they come, some of them, you have to have fear.
Baba wa ba fitla o tshwara ke poifo.
And they must cast that fear away.
And ba tsontsholele ka poifo yeo.
But it's different with Jesus here.
Ya nta ba ifa pana le taba ya Jesu.
Jesus says,
Jesu ore,
I will make myself real to you.
Na ke ta dira hore ke be wa thereisho le no ba ke bonagale.
And this starts with the word.
And taba e thomaka le ntshe.
The word will be real to you.
Le ntshe le taba thereisho.
You read the word, you see Jesus.
Le tloba la ntshe la bona Jesu.
The real story.
La bona thereisho ya taba e.
It becomes part of you.
E thomo ba karolo ya rena.
I don't know if you are hearing that.
A ke tseba le ntwa.
Pastor will say, is the word real to you?
Bo tshamto le ngafa le ntshe le le na le thereisho.
Is Jesus real to you?
Jesu wa ya bonagala o wena na.
If we read Mark
10
and we read from verse 17,
ra bala to verse 17,
you find a young man.
Ri thola mothankana o ba motho muswa.
This man, when he came to Jesus, he said,
mona wa afita u Jesu uri,
Jesus, I want to follow you. Jesus said, okay,
Jesu kenya go shala marao Jesu a rulukile.
You need to obey all commandments.
O thoka o shala marao di taelo ka moka.
And this young man says, I followed all.
Are not skin chiki di shala marao.
And our Lord Jesus say, okay, go and sell everything.
Jesu are yo nonga etsa mayo yo rekisha ka moka cha unang li tsona.
And come and follow me.
O te o ntshale marao ge
botse. This was the word that was given, the word that instructed.
Le le filweng le ne le
nae. The word of Jesus, go and sell everything.
Le je la mana Jesu tsa mayo yo rekisa he ka o fela.
Come and follow me.
O te o khono shala marao.
Was offended.
Mona wa go pishea.
And Jesus say, can you see it's so difficult?
Jesu are go
buima. In riches.
Ro u bote magomo
and still believe in God.
O tswele pele o satumela go motheme.
It's so difficult.
O buima
to enter heaven.
O ro tsene le go dimo.
When you trust in riches.
Ha u bote le magomo.
Yeah, we can see the word.
Mo re gona bona le ntshe.
I mean, and the riches
magomo
replacing each other.
A replace no ba a yemela no ba tshela na tulo.
What we need to value more is the word of God.
We thump off
that the riches of the world.
O fetisha magoma le fasile.
Tell me, we need to value more.
Mo tsha motoleng khofe a re going re thumping
the word from Jesus.
Le ntshile le thangwa mo rena Jesu.
The riches of the world.
O fetisha magoma le fasile.
This man was limited somewhere.
Na ona le mafukutse leng teng.
He was doing some things.
Na ona le dilo tsa
ditirao.
Mara dilo tseo.
Will not make him a disciple.
Na di sa modirura be go a gona ba morutiwa.
But Jesus wanted to bring him closer.
Mara Jesu na yakho motisa gaoswe.
And he said, you need to sell all.
O rekisha ka moka.
Is the position you are having.
Ke siemo se oneng le sona.
That affect you.
Se se affecta mo wena.
And failing to follow.
O felletse go palelwa go ntsha la morao.
Because you cannot be a disciple of Jesus.
Le ba ka sebe morutiwa wa morena Jesu.
And you don't do his will.
Wa se dire le ntshe la gae.
I don't know if you're hearing that.
A ke tseba le ntwa.
You cannot be a disciple of Jesus.
O ka sebe tshe morutiwa wa morena Jesu.
And you don't do his will.
Wa se dire le ntshe la gae.
So he was given instruction.
Ga no wela fe wa taela.
Of righteousness.
Ya utuko.
What you can do now.
Ga no nto ka idea ngana jwale.
Everything
when are kisa kamoka
and come and follow me.
O te onchale morao.
When you are following me, you will do what I say.
Na o onchala morao to dia ka mogho ke bolela.
And because he was rich.
Mona o ka lebaka la rena a gomile.
He had limitation.
Aba le mafoko tsa yang ntse.
Obeying God's will.
A palwa ko latela le ntshela modimo.
Can I tell you this? There are many people here.
Ngona le batho ba ntshe. Ba bana le mo ba foko tsa yang ntse.
Because they are rich on the certain area.
O bana ba gomile plekeng tshedingwe.
And when God say leave those things and come to me.
E motho a re tuela tsho nang le tsho na o te.
It becomes difficult to follow Jesus.
In Mark 8:34-38.
We can see that we must be ready to sacrifice.
Re bona re tsontse ke mishetsa o niela o ba ufana.
If we want to do God's word.
Aranya go dira thato ya papa ba lentshela modimo.
We must be ready to sacrifice. Can you read verse 34?
Re tsontse ba batho ba re ke mishetsa.
Mark 8.
Mareka 8.
Yes, he said what?
When he had called the people to himself,
yes,
with his disciples also, he said to them, whoever desires to come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever desires to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake and the gospel's sake will save it. For what will it profit a man if he gain the whole world and loses his own soul? Or what will a man give in exchange for his soul? For whoever is ashamed of me in my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of him the Son of Man also will be ashamed when he comes in his glory of his Father with the holy angels.
Here you can see Jesus was teaching, proving that God's word is important.
Oh,
his word is important.
Or
him is important. Because you cannot separate him with his word. The Bible says, in the beginning, he was there. He was the word. So if you read there, you see that sacrificial is needed. You must reach a level where even when it's difficult to go where you do it, you reach a level where it's impossible to do it, but you do it. How many times we found that we need to be celebrated? We want people to beat us at the back, tap us at the back, and say congratulations. But it's contrary with the word of God. Tell your neighbor, you need to sacrifice. You must reach a level where you can lose all for God's word. I'm obeying God's word. I'm hearing that, okay, if I obey God's word, they will leave me. I don't care. I'm obeying God's word. I'm carrying on obeying God's word. And the same people will celebrate me. You know, what is important is God's word now. It's not a gift of the Spirit, it's God's word. It's not to prophesy, it's God's word.
Aso prophet akelinjela modimo.
If God's word is in you,
alinjela modimo le ntse go wena.
And you are ready to die for it.
Ena wena o ikemisele tse go gwela lona.
To lose your life for it.
Wa lathelwa ke bophelo
ke lona. There's no way God won't visit you.
A ona tsela ya re modimo ba sa wete.
There will be revelations that will come to us.
Tla le dikotollo tse di tautelang.
We must reach a level where we take God's word as the ultimate. Okay, I can see what is happening, but if I have to die, I have to die for God's word. I don't know if you're hearing me. I know many people in
Charis
who were told that they must leave
Charis
and go to a church that does not worship God. They say this marriage can be useless to me. A temptation of God's word is when you are challenged if you will obey it. You challenge if you will obey it. Friends leave you. Husband and wife leave you. But you say, I'm standing on God's word until I see something. Therefore, it's important to know God's word so that you'll be able to challenge whoever challenges you. Remember, even Jesus said, I can rather die of hunger here than to do what you are saying, to change the stones and make them food and make them bread. I can rather die of hunger here. I'm not desperate here. This is God's word. If God say, I must not fornicate, I won't do that. Even if you won't buy me grocery, I won't do that. It's God's word. I don't know if you're hearing me. It's God's word. Don't be angry. It's God's word. I've got a reason to show my anger, but because God's word says this, I won't do that. I don't know if you're hearing me. Let me try to tell you that many people.
Rekeleka ngolibucha batuwa bangata.
Who are very rough people.
Baba leng batuwa leng rafukudu.
After they meet Jesus.
Kamra woko panali Jesu.
You will even think they are pretending.
Otanaka nana lure ba iketsisa.
Because they see the importance.
Karabatomo bana butokwa. Bali nchula mudim.
I don't know if you're hearing me.
Aketsa balen.
They can rather be stupid for God's word.
Bana baba di taela odi la nchula mudim.
Or lose their lives for God's word.
Balatela kubupilo baba na odi la nchula mudim.
I'm sure you're hearing what I'm trying to say.
Yatimela le kwata ba iki bolela.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
John 15.
Johane 15.
If we read from 14 to 16.
Arekabala 14 to 16.
Know that you declare yourself friends of Jesus.
Li itira ba wera ba Jesu.
When you obey God's word.
Alinali kwali nchula mudim.
Jesus said, you are no longer the servants.
Alisale ba shanka.
Because they don't know the plan of God.
Kaban ba shanka ba zibi plani ya mudim uliba wera baka.
We do things together.
Ready adin tomo.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
So just read verse 14.
Arabaleng verse 14.
He said what?
You are my friends if you do whatever I command you.
That is the first thing.
Into
you are my friends.
Leba wera baka.
If you do whatever I command
you. Sona sona.
The second thing reads.
Sabubedi, no longer do I call you servants. For a servant does not know what his master is doing. But I have called you friends. For all things that I heard from my father, I have made known to you.
There are things that will never pass you.
The
plan of the Father to our lives will be known by us through
Jesus.
Listen to this, you must know the plan. Why are you here in life? Why? Because you are no longer servants. When you obey God's ways, you end up finding the revelation of yourself. You end up knowing why are you existing. Number three, carry on reading, Mama. Yes.
You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruits.
That is the third thing. When you obey God's ways, you become a person who produces fruits.
O vale motho ya tang le dienywa ya tsweletsang dienywa.
Of showing that you are chosen.
Ya o bontsho re ka nnete o hlaotswe.
Listen to this, you are chosen to produce something.
Ore wena o tsweletse sengwe.
People must know that you are producing something.
Wa ho batho ba tsotse bo re tsweletse se sengwe.
Listen, you cannot be following God's way, God's way, God's way without fruits.
O ka sa lintse la morao ka mora ka lintse la modimo ka morao ka mora.
The Bible says we'll know you by your fruits.
Bible re ta o tseba ka dienywa.
Your character also will show us.
Mekgwa ya gao le yona e tla re bontsha.
What you do, you will tell us.
Ntwetse o di diang na o re tlo re bontsha.
What you are doing, you are telling us.
Tse we na o di diang o tabo re boditse.
You will bear fruits.
O tla enya dienywa.
That shows that you are chosen.
Tsa o bontsha re ka nnete o kgethilwe.
Listen to this.
Tshele chang.
This year there have to be fruits.
Mwa ha o tsontsho ba le dienywa.
Of showing that you are chosen.
Tsa o bontsha re na re kgethilwe.
I just declare to someone who's listening to me.
A go ke bolela motho mongwe a
ntse. If you obey God's word.
A wena o ikwa lentshe la motho.
Very soon.
Sekhale.
There will be fruits that shows you are chosen.
O tla ba le dienywa tsa o bontsha re ka nnete o kgethilwe.
The last one is what?
Ya mafelelo ke
efe. The last one there.
And that your fruits shall remain.
Yes.
That whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give to you. He
Listen
may
to
give
this.
You.
When you are in God's word, when you ask anything from the Father through the name of
Jesus,
it shall come to pass. If you want to see why we are not getting results, it's because we don't have God's word.
Ke ka le bakala o ra rena lentse la modimo.
Once we have God's word.
A re ka tshora lentse la modimo.
We ask.
A re gopela.
Anything.
Ke lo checka moka.
It will happen.
Di tlo dirahana.
There is something that I've asked from God.
Ona lentse nna ke gopetseng modimo.
I want to tell you.
Ke nyako le thalosetsa yona.
I want you to be an example of the family.
Ke nyako re lebe tshopo la peng la gaeno.
Where you were born. I want to see. I want people to see that you're an example of
the family.
So that they worship your God. It's easy for people to change and to listen to you. It's when you have got fruits of righteousness. Fruits from the Spirit. When you ask anything and it happens, I tell someone now, I declare to someone that whatever you are asking from God, it will happen this year. Listen, this year must never come to an end without your testimony. Just stay in God's word.
Wena dulali ching la muti.
It's a formula for you.
Kitsela ya how.
It's a formula for you to produce.
Kitsela ya how uruchwe.
What is required?
Intoche nyakeha.
If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Awo chumela nkeora hallelujah.
Can you read James 1?
Are yemo la ku Jacob 1.
From verse 19 to 22.
Otoa ku verse 19 to 22.
You will see that a man have got two nature.
Ota tolo ro motunwa le tha uche pedi.
One of the nature there is.
Yemo ya chona.
A hearer.
Ki utwa.
And a doer.
Le mudiri.
The Bible says when we hear God's word.
Are itole inshola motimo ira lo Bible.
We must be a doer.
Retsoncho ba badiri.
Not a hearer.
Ising bakwi.
Listen, otherwise if we are hearer.
Aw si tshola re le bakwi fela.
We won't produce those fruits.
Re ka sto tshole tsa duenywa tshela dinyakehang.
We won't reach a level where people will serve our God.
Re ka si among sela modi batho ba thoma go boifa motimo.
I don't know if you are hearing me.
A ke tseba leng kwa.
Can you read Psalm 50?
Psalm 50.
Verse 15.
Verse 15.
I want to show you why sometimes when we call God and he doesn't answer us.
Psalm 50 verse 15.
Read, mama. Psalm 50 verse 15.
Call upon me in the day of trouble.
Yes.
I will deliver you and you shall glorify me.
It's when you have got God's word.
Ke una le lentse la modimo.
Call upon me when by the time of trouble. And I will deliver you. Read, continue, mama.
But to the wicked, God says, what right have you to declare my statutes or take my covenant in your mouth?
Yes.
Seeing you hate instruction and cast my ways behind you.
It's only 22, mama. Let me read 22. Now consider this, you who forget God, lest I tear you in pieces. If you can see here, you will see that the character that was mentioned, you become a partaker with the adulterer. You speak against your brother. And your tongues frame dissent. You slander anybody. And when God is silent, don't ever think he won't come. Can I tell you this? Sometimes God can be silent for your repentance, but don't ever think he won't come. But he who dwell in God's word, he will call upon him and God will answer. I don't know if you're hearing me. Listen to this. When they are challenging you, when they are fighting you, stay in God's word. Don't answer them when they speak against you, when they slander you, when they accuse you, whatever the character they are showing, stay in God's word. And when you call, he's about to answer. I believe today the Lord will answer someone. I don't care your situation. It's only God's word that becomes a key to our success. It's only God's word that becomes a breakthrough to our lives. If you believe, say amen. Look what happened to Timothy. In 2 Timothy 3, if we can read, let's read maybe from verse 10.
Verse 10.
Just read there. What was happening by the time of Timothy?
Paul
was telling Timothy that there are many things, but you stay on what you have learned. There are many things. Stay in the word of God. Can you read 10 to 17, mama?
But you have carefully followed my doctrine.
Yes.
Manner of life, purpose, faith, long suffering, love, perseverance, persecutions, afflictions, which happens to me at Antioch, at Iconia, at Lystra, what persecutions I endured, and out of them all the Lord delivered me. Yes. And all who desire to live godly in Christ Jesus will suffer persecution. But evil men and impostors will grow worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. But you must continue in the things which you have learned and been assured of, knowing from whom you have learned them, and that from childhood you have known the holy scriptures, which are able to make you wise for salvation, though through faith which is in Christ Jesus. All scripture is given by an inspiration of God, and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be complete, thoroughly equipped for every good work.
If you can hear that, you see that Paul was telling Timothy
that
many things are happening. Even what is happening now, it has been happening before. But you, Timothy, stay in God's word. Stay in the scripture you have learned. Because people will deceive and be deceived. People will do whatever things they can do. But you stay on what you have learned. Listen to this. Stay in God's word makes you different. I don't know if you're hearing me. Sometimes you must reach a level where you say, I can see that other people are moving forward. But I just want to stay in God's word. God's way. I want to obey God's way. So Paul said, Timothy, stay in God's way until you are honored. Remember, when you stay in God's
way,
it's Jesus who pray to the Father so that the Holy Spirit will come. And that's Holy Spirit will be the Spirit of the truth. That is not known by the world. So automatically you will be different with the world. It's only God's word that can assign you and put you in a different state than the state of the world. When Paul spoke about it, he said, do not be conformed with the world. Allow the world to go that side when you are going on another side. I want you people to know what is important is God's word. If you stay in God's word and you just stay there, obey that God's word, very soon you'll be example. I don't know if you're hearing me. I say you'll be example. Today we are reading about Timothy. We are about to read about you. I say we are about to read about you. Because of God's word. One time I used to stay for the whole day reading the Bible. And I realized it's not normal. We must have a desire. And we're able to stay in the word. And we enjoy that word until God does something. By then I was not a pastor. I'll just take my Bible, I go to school. I open, I read there. Write my notes there. And I was enjoying it. I don't know if you're hearing me. I didn't know what God was doing. You cannot fail when you trust God's word. I don't know if you're hearing me. Your situation might not be showing anything. But I'm here to tell you that word is like a seed in you. Very soon people will see you in a different way because of God's word. I'm very worried about our generation. Our generation now, it's holding the spiritual gifts without the word of God. And automatically it's possible for you to sin. So it raises questions of which kind of spirit now is working on you. Because remember, the spirit will come to you because of Jesus, praying for you to the Father. I'm very worried about the way we are doing things. Our focus is not in the word. If our focus is in the word, automatically that word by its nature
lela katao ya lona.
It will change our character.
Lito fetu sa mehwaya reina.
And it will represent Jesus.
Ena reina rata kona uyemela morena Jesus.
I don't know if you're hearing me.
Na ketsa borile ntona.
I want to challenge someone today.
Nakenya ko challenge mutumwe lekhon.
That if you can stay only one week.
Ora awena ukadurla beke tifela.
That character, that habit.
Mukwawo la oba mukholona lingwona.
You are failing to change.
Upalela o fetula.
You will overcome it.
Ota shumla mukwawo.
In the name of Jesus.
Kalina la Christi Jesus.
I don't know if you're hearing me.
Ngetsa ba le ntwa.
I said there's a habit.
Kere one le mukwa.
That anger.
Mukwa wala wa utine.
That worry.
Uvilela hola.
Will leave you.
Ota utugela.
And it's a stumbling block.
Ena apena kisi shitishi ntwena.
That devil is using.
Yantwe satana.
To block your miracle.
Otswala motholo wa hao.
If you stay in God's word.
Tana ma ukadula linching la papa.
It will transform you.
Tana linching la papa lito ufitusa.
And remove what is not needed.
Tana ngala tusantwe sanya kering mwena.
It will refine you.
Lito umpiafaza.
And instruct you.
La ulayela.
The direction you are needed.
La uisa tilingi unyake ya unza.
I don't know if you hear me.
Na ketsa
vaka. If you hear me say I hear.
Alinto iringi tuile.
Let me tell someone who's hearing.
Ere kitaru seche motu munga unkwanga na juale.
This week when you stay in God's word.
Beke ya ukadula kara linching la papa.
Even that desire you are crying for.
La uilelang
will come your way.
Ito tatseleng ya gao.
If you believe shout hallelujah.
O tumela nke ore hallelujah.
I saw that God was able to do everything by his word.
Ke bona go motemona gona o di adilo ka ofela ka lentsi la
gae. But I love Psalm 107.
Ke mara ke rata Psalm 107.
Verse 20.
Verse 20.
That say he sent forth his word.
O rumela lentsi la gae.
And healed them.
Aba fodisha.
And he rescues them
aba lukulla
from their destruction by his word.
O fedishwa nga bona ka lentsi la gae.
Jesus used his word.
Jesus shumisha lentsi la gae.
You could see that healing here.
Wa gona bona re fodisha mo ka lentsi la
gae. He sent forth his word.
O rumela lentsi la gae.
Any miracle by his word.
O tholoka o fela mo le mongwe ka lentsi la
gae. Your heart is by his word.
Lentsi ka o fela dilo tse ka lentsi la
gae. Let me send forth the word of God.
Ah, David o shumela lentsi.
Today when you are listening to me.
Le gona ha lentsi le tse ka mogolo.
What you are crying for.
Ntse le dilelang le gona.
It's coming your way. The name of Jesus.
Ke tsenga lena ka le biso la Jesu.
I say it's coming your way.
Ke diye tatsilenga lena ka leina la Jesu.
Jesus spoke that in Matthew 24.
Jesu kule tshita vayela mola go Matthew 24.
Especially in verse 35.
Kudukudu mola o verse 35.
He say heaven and earth.
Uri le wodi mola le fase.
As we know it now.
Jola ka a re tsebana
jwa. Will pass away.
It will fade.
But his way.
Mara le njela ha elona.
Will never pass.
Le ka tsweli fitile.
I'm sending the word of Jesus.
Na ke mama mantjenga morena Jesu ana jwa le.
I say what you are crying for.
Ke nto ile la ngwanesho.
Today.
Le khono le.
You are receiving a relief.
Le na le amogela ku tokolo.
In the name of Jesus.
Ka le bitso la Jesu.
When I said the name of Jesus, the word of Jesus.
Ke le bitso la ja ke le ntjela Jesu.
I said it in the name of Jesus.
Ke bolela ka le bitso la Jesu.
I said today.
Ke le khono le.
What you are crying for.
Nto tele na le dilela.
It's coming your way.
That's telling you
in the name of Jesus.
Ka le bitso la Jesu.
Listen.
Tell it.
It is the word you read.
Ke lentjele o lebalang.
And the word you receive from the Holy Spirit.
Lentjele lo ya mogala mo moya o mogetho.
That when they meet.
Le tara ha dikopana dilo tse.
They bring the heart desire.
It is to moya pelo ya lena.
They bring what God desire for you.
It is ntwe modimo a idumelang lena.
Sometimes what you are desiring.
Sa bona go tshe dingwe ntotshe le di dumang lena.
It's not what God want to give you.
A se ntotshe mpapanya kon le fatse gona.
But when you take the word of God in you.
Ma ha o challenge la modimo wa lebe ya wena.
It gives a right scope for you.
Lentjele tsa to just swane tshengo dia wena.
You begin to see things.
O thoma o bona dilo ka mogho mo dingwa di bonang ka gona.
And he bring them the way.
And we are the this
you are not expecting.
Ye wena no sai libelela.
I don't know if you are hearing me.
Na ke tsebalento.
You must stay in God's way.
O tsho dula ka ra lentse la modimo.
If you abide in his way.
Ha wena o ka dula lentseng la gae.
Whatever you ask.
Ka mo ka tsho to ya ngwa di gopela.
It shall come to pass.
Ito ta di petaga le go wena.
Look when Joshua was told.
A go libelela Joshua ha bolele.
Joshua not left or right.
O ska libelela thakurela go jo balang.
When
I do not know anishi sha bo tshulo bo tshia le ntshile la modimo.
If you do that,
and
you
don't know how ka thoma wa dira so na ka tshisha o tata ho atea.
Listen, this is the man.
Ye o ke motho.
Who saw Moses.
Ye na bona Moshe.
And
ke a hlula dilo tse ka ofela batho ka moka.
And when he took over the position,
na a tshia se Mosela.
God commanded him.
Modimo a molaela.
Wherever you put your leg.
Ke motho ha tangona ka le uto.
Dominate.
O ta tshia taulo.
If you are working in a company.
shuma company tsoko.
You dominate.
Oto chata ulo.
If you are working somewhere.
Awena ushuma kai kai.
When your leg is there.
Awena lutola kaule hata.
You are more than the conqueror.
Ufitisha baba shutse.
And that word.
Ene jono li.
Was given to Joshua.
Ne li filwe Joshua.
Meditate.
Ale wena na ganisha. Yeshiko le montsi are.
The word.
Ale chile le chile.
You will make your way.
Kiwa na we uta dia ditsela cha.
Prosperous.
Uri dia teye.
Today.
Jono li kono leke.
You have blocked somewhere.
Re na rotola le le kai kai.
You need God's word.
Utoka lintula mutimu wa ne.
You need God's word.
Utoka lintula papa.
And I'm giving you a word now.
Jono kufali ntsha shile.
Your way is open.
Awu ibule ile.
Your way is open.
Kaya awu ibule ile.
In the name of Jesus.
Kali viso la Kriste Jesu.
It becomes God's word.
Itomo bali ntsha.
When I say in the name of Jesus.
Itomo re kali viso la Jesu.
I say you are sick.
Kiri walwala.
I say by the stripes of Jesus.
Kiri marakadi ntsha cha Kriste Jesu.
You are healed today.
Shitwe le khona.
In the name of Jesus.
Viso la Jesu.
Viso la Jesu. I'm giving you God's word.
Ke le fengle ntshela modimo.
I say you can be.
Ke re wena o ka ba.
Wa
di chelete le gono.
By God's word.
Ka le ntshela modimo.
I don't know if you are hearing that.
Ka ke se bo le ntona.
God's word is upon you.
Ntshela modimo le go dimo a rena.
Is in your heart today.
Le go pelong ya lena le gono.
Whatever you are crying for.
Ka mo ka tshe wena o di llela.
Receive it right now.
Ya mogele gana jwale.
Receive it right now.
Ya mogele gana jwale.
Receive it right now.
Ya mogele gana jwale.
I love Paul when he spoke God's word.
Paul avela linjela modimo.
When there was a shipwreck.
Ali sina watlele tube.
Everybody was hopeless.
Motoka ofela khulofela itsamaile.
And Paul stood up.
Ore Paul a emelela bolela.
Everybody was sitting, others were sleeping.
Motoka ofela na a dutse fase
wa ba. Waters were everywhere.
Metse na tetse go gotheka ra lesela watle.
And there was a shipwreck.
And then ona le tube ga lesela watle.
And before it was a shipwreck.
And then no pile we ba lesela watlele we.
They were fighting so that they stay on the water.
Ba lwa gore ba dule ba le go dimo a metse.
But there was no stable.
Mara ne go sina o dudishaya.
The Bible says.
Iri Bible ya papa.
They had cargo.
Wa jana o mirwalo ye ne bana le yona ba
tshiya
ka ofela ba ile thela metse
to lighten the ship
o re ba diele sila kwa telebe bo
fe so
o re ba dule ba le go dimo ha budi
carry on sailing
ba tshele pele ba ya pele ka
le yeto but it was not working
ka le batla ka le toka na go yona di sa
pele they were hopeless
jana o ne ba sa thola bana le kulu fe
the angel descend from
Rome wa mo dimo a thewela mo bo bona
and spoke with Paul
a fita bo le di tshana le Paul
Paul you have lost cargo
o e ole la thetse ke mirwalo
you will even lose the ship
le tola thelwa le ka sila watele
but no one will die
mara una bophilo bo botola
you will see Rome
le to bona Roma
I'm here for a God's word
mo ka le bakala le tshela papa
I'm here to tell you
niki moto le thalosetsa
you might have lost all
le nana le ka balela phetse ka tsa
moka you have lost all
le la phetse ke dilo ka moka
but you will reach the destiny
le fita mo le yang teng
where God wants you to be
ka mo di manya ka go le fita
you are going to reach there
le la to fita ke mo le yang
if you believe shout
hallelujah
I'm giving you God's word
ke le fengle nje papa
you have lost the cargo
o la thetse ke mirwalo
you have lost cars
o la thetse ke dikoloi
you have lost properties
o la thetse ke dilo
you have lost friends
o la thetse ke mogotse
and you are hopeless
and a o sana khulufela
but I'm giving you a word
ala go fali ntshile le botse ya sele
this is the word for you
le ke le ntshile le tango wena
you will reach where God
o fita mala papa
say you will reach
ai tsengwe ta fita
you won't die
o ka sishwe
you will reach there
o fita mo yang ke
it's God's word for you
o le ntshile mo dimo shile mo
for you
inchela modimo goya
I see God's way
na ke bona le inchela modimo
working in the spirit
lisho mamoyeng
producing your heart desire
le tsa tomo cha pili ya rena
I see God's way
ke bona le inchela modimo
giving out what you have been praying for
le chanto tela khale le le
le le take someone
ka tare fita motho mo tsele
those who say is finished with you
ba na ba bolela go ru fetile ka rena
about to be surprised
ba
go
fino go makala ka maphilo a rena
I see God's way
ka wa mwele le inchela pa
receive prosperity
Receive
healing.
Kwa wamgele podisho.
Receive healing. In the name of Jesus.
Ina la Kriste Jesu.
Congratulations.
Le bale thogonolo.